Blessed be God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Angel with the Orthodox Church. Welcome to the Gospel for July the 7th, 2021, according to Saint Luke. Inasmuch as many have taken in hand to send in order a narrative of those things which have been fulfilled among us, just as those who from the beginning were eyewitnesses and ministers of the word delivered them to us, it seemed good to me also, having had perfect understanding of all things from the very first, to write to you an orderly account, most excellent Theophilus, that you may know the certainty of those things in which you were instructed. There was, in the days of Herod, the king of Judea, a certain priest named Zacharias, of the division of Abijah. His wife was of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth, and they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blameless. But they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren, and they were both well advanced in years. So it was, while he was serving as priest before God in the order of his division, according to the custom of the priesthood, his lot fell to burn incense when he went into the temple of the Lord. And the whole multitude of the people was praying outside at the door at the hour of incense. Then an angel of the Lord appeared to him standing on the right hand of the altar of incense. And when Zacharias saw him, he was troubled, and fear fell upon him. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zacharias, for your prayer is heard. And your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you shall call his name John. And you will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth. For he will be great in the sight of the Lord, and shall drink neither wine nor strong drink. He will also be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother's womb. And he will turn many of the children of Israel to the Lord their God. He will also go before him in the spirit and power of Elijah, to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the disobedient to the wisdom of the just, to make ready a people prepared for the Lord." And Zacharias said to the angel, "How shall I know this? For I am an old man, and my wife is well advanced in years." And the angel answered and said to him, "I am Gabriel, who stands in the presence of God, and was sent to speak to you and bring you these glad tidings. But behold, you will be mute and not be able to speak until the day these things take place, because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled in their own time." And the people waited for Zacharias, and marveled that he lingered so long in the temple. But when he came out, he could not speak to them, and they perceived that he had seen a vision in the temple. So he beckoned to them and remained speechless. So it was, as soon as the days of his servants were completed, that he departed to his own house. Now, after those days, his wife Elizabeth conceived, and she hid herself 5 months, saying, "Thus the Lord has dealt with me in the days when he looked on me to take away my reproach among people." Now Elizabeth's full time came to her to be delivered, and she brought forth a son. When her neighbors and relatives heard how the Lord had shown great mercy to her, they rejoiced with her. So it was on the eighth day that they came to circumcise the child, and they would have called him by the name of his father Zacharias. His mother answered and said, "No, he shall be called John." But they said to her, "There is no one among your relatives who is called by this name." So they made signs to his father what he would have him called. And he asked for a writing tablet and wrote, saying, "His name is John." So they all marveled. Immediately his mouth was opened, and his tongue loosened, and he spoke praising God. Then fear came on all who dwelt among them, and all these sayings were discussed throughout all the hill country of Judea. And all those who heard them kept them in their hearts, saying, "What kind of child will this be?" And the hand of the Lord was with him. Now his father Zacharias was filled with the Holy Spirit and prophesied, saying, "Blessed is the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people. And you, child, will be called the prophet of the highest, for you will go before the face of the Lord to prepare his ways, So the child grew and became strong in spirit, and was in the desert till the day of his manifestation to Israel. Glory be to thee, O God, glory be to thee. Christ is in our midst. He is and ever will be. Dear brothers, today we have a very beautiful gospel for the nativity of Saint John the Baptist. The Baptist, the precursor. And I just would like to dwell on how this old priest, who was a righteous person, would not give credit to the words of the angel. And thus he became mute. For 9 months he had to remain mute, or even more, a little bit more, because he did not believe the words of God spoken through his angel. When he wrote the name that had been told to him, then his heart was filled with joy. The greatest man born of a woman was born the son of Zechariah and Elizabeth, the prophet and the precursor of our Lord and God and Savior, Jesus Christ. And we should praise the Lord and obey him and believe him, that we might be free. For blessed is our God, always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.